Hello and good morning, YouTube and America. As far as the coronavirus, we shall overcome. I am doing a review today on, you guessed it, the Glock 19, and it's actually a Gen 4. It is a striker fire pistol. Very, very easy to use, very, very reliable. We put, I'd say, at least 3,000 rounds to this using either grain and steel. And still have had no issues. Cleaned it, you know, always clean it. Comes with, you know, with 3 14 round mags, not doing an unboxing, just basically, you know, giving you the basic features. Has an ambidextrous slide, has an ambidextrous slide release, which can actually be changed. The gun is not loaded, so I can do this for you. And I like safety. But it's very reliable. Shoots very accurate. The thing that I do not like about Glock, you know, other than the price, is that it comes with plastic sights. You know, you can go get an HK or a SIG, and it comes equipped with nice steel sights. You know, that's basically my only gripe about the Glock 19. It shoots very, very well. And again, it's very accurate. I know I'm saying the same thing about it, but it's very easy to use. However, the trigger, not so great. So let's do the trigger again here. I'm going to show you where it breaks. See, you have the trigger, and if you see it, it breaks right about there. And then we're going to do the release. So it's pretty not crisp for an out-of-the-box gun, but, you know, the thing about Glock is it has some of the best aftermarket accessories, okay? You can get a 33-round mag for a Glock. That's an aftermarket accessory that you cannot get with a lot of other striker pistols in the market, even though the market is saturated. Glock parts to see when it comes to aftermarket accessories. You know, you have the M&P, you know, which has decent accessories, but Glock is numero uno. Definitely going to change out the sights. We add an optic. Freak it out a little bit here. A lot of things that people do not like about the Gen 4 versus the 5 is the actual finger grooves. It does not bother me one bit. Like I said, my basic thing is, yeah, to be the actual sights. That's really my biggest gripe, and possibly upgrade to the Apex trigger kit to get a more accurate crisp trigger. Those are pretty much, you know, the basic things that I would add. Taking a gun apart is pretty easy. You have your slide releases here on the side. I'm not going to take it apart, just doing basic features. The trigger guard is pretty wide, so you can get your finger in there. Again, the gun is empty, so I don't want to hear about trigger discipline. Yeah, but the gun is clear, so then still pointing in a, you know, a safe direction. You know, still don't want to point even the empty gun to me. But yeah, it's a great gun. Something I would recommend to anyone that's getting out there. You know, about $500 to $600. We have a great, reliable gun. I'm not a Glock fanboy. Glock is not the end all be all. There are a lot of great pistols out here in the market. But if I want to recommend a reliable pistol to someone that's going to work every time, I'll definitely recommend a Glock 19. Doesn't matter the generation. They just work. They're reliable. And the aftermarket accessories are just abundant. So this is my very, very, very first video. I'm just freestyling, so I'm not really having anything scripted here. But again, it's just the basic features that I just wanted to go over. You know, you have some slide serrations here on the back, not on the front. But, you know, like I said, you can always customize it and change anything that you want up on it. The only thing I'm going to do with it is I'm going to change the sights, and then we're going to put an Apex trigger in here, and we're good to go. All right, guys. Be safe, stay armed. God bless America. Goodbye.